Grace. Hi. How are you?
Fine.
So I need to ask you a couple of questions first off.
Okay.
So, are you new to yoga or you've done some yoga before?
Some yoga, but not in the water.
Oh, first time on the water?
Yeah.
Okay, fantastic. And how's your feeling in the water?
A little bit scared.
Can you swim?
Yes, I can swim in the swimming pool, not in the ocean.
Okay, so actually this water is deep enough for you, if you fall off, that you won't hurt yourself, you won't hit the bottom, but at the same time you'll be able to stand up.
Okay.
So no issue if you fall off the board today. There shouldn't be no reason to be scared about falling off, right? It's part of the fun of doing yoga on the board.
Okay.
Yeah? Also, what do you think might be some of the risks that might in this environment for us?
I don't think any risk can happen in here, but maybe if someone draws it, you don't know how to swim, I guess you will touch the bottom.
Yep. There might also be a risk, I mean this is why we do it in this depth of water, so that if you fall off that there isn't any risk of you hurting yourself. But this is also why we tie ourselves to a rope. Because there shouldn't be any chance that you fall off and hit your head anywhere, like on the side or on the stairs or anything like that. So it's quite safe for us here because we're tied to this rope.
Okay.
And you can't move further than this blue one, so you won't end up over there and I won't end up over there.
Okay.
The only thing I'll be careful of is that I don't come too close to you.
Okay.
So that if I fall off, that I'm going to disturb you, right? Or if you fall off, you'll disturb me. So I'll pay attention to that. You don't need to worry about it.
Okay.
And the other thing that we should be conscious of is just if anybody else enters the pool today.
Mm-hmm.
But right now, none of our guests are here.
Yay!
Everybody's outside. So we're not expecting anyone to enter the pool, but if anyone comes around, then I'll also pay attention to that.
Okay.
And then there's something also in the sky that we have to consider today.
Really? Yeah.
What might that be?
It's so hot.
It's very warm.
Yeah.
So over here in India, the sun is a bit scorching. It's the middle of the day. So have you taken any sun protection precautions?
Yes.
You have?
Yeah.
Okay, good. And did you wash your hands afterwards? Because sometimes the sunscreen can make you slippery on the board.
Yes.
Yeah, you're all good?
All good.
Okay, if we need more sunscreen, we have some over here at the side.
Okay.
And Sarah, our film expert, might pass it to us if we need it.
Okay.
And also the other thing, because it's hot, maybe we feel like we need to drink water during the class today.
Okay.
If we do, there's also water over here at the side.
Okay.
That we've got in the shade. So if we need that, our film expert Sarah might send that to us as well. And just so that everybody knows, Sarah's sitting here filming, but she's also taken her own sun protection. She's wearing a hat, she's got her sunglasses on. So I think we've taken care of as many of the risks that we can.
Okay.
So we want to settle in and have a good yoga practice today on the board, yeah?
Yeah, looking forward.
Excellent. Okay, so just a couple of things about the board.
Mm-hmm.
The end that's attached to the rope for you is the nose. I have my nose around the other end because my board has a bit of a hole in it, right?
Okay.
So I'm using my board like upside down today. But your nose is attached to the rope. The more important thing for you to know is where the centre of gravity of the board is, and these boards are fantastic because they have a big OM symbol in the middle.
Okay.
So just take a look at that and see where the OM is, yeah?
Oh, I can see it.
Yeah, you can see it?
Yeah.
So that's where the board's going to be most stable.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, so when we're sitting on the board, we want to sit on our OM symbol. But also when we're doing all kinds of other yoga poses, when we're starting to move into some standing poses, the center of gravity for us is always going to be on that arm. So sometimes I might say to you, I'll bring your weight forward or make sure you've got your belly centered on the arm or whatever, just so that we can have some nice stability on the board. I mean, also these boards are, according to me, very buoyant and very stable, but you might want to just test your board a little. rock from side to side and feel how much stability you have in the board. Sometimes when you fall off the board, it can be a bit tricky to remember, but we want to try and fall flat as much as we can. We want to try and fall backwards and flat. It'll be quite elegant in our falling, because that will help us have more surface area of the body falling onto the water, less chance of like going down and hitting the bottom. Yeah? So try and fall flat. Alright.
I would try that.
Yeah. Okay, so let's sit ourselves up nice and deep, right? You might want to roll your shoulders up and down. And bring your hands to your knees wherever they feel comfortable. You can palms facing up, palms facing down. It doesn't really matter. And let's close our eyes. And just start to connect with the feeling of being on the water. Underneath the base of your spine. And the sounds that you hear around you. Sounds that are far away, traffic, maybe some of the team working, maybe things in the kitchen. That closer sound, the sound of the water lapping around the edges of the pool. And as you start to just settle down, just bring your awareness to yourself sitting on the board and to your breath. For a moment, bring your left hand up onto your heart center and your right hand to your belly. And feel your breath as you inhale and exhale. And feel those hands just slightly moving away as you inhale. And slightly coming back in as you exhale. Bring your hands back to your knees. Continue to feel that breath as your body rises and falls. Being perfect, looking amazing. Let's keep more focused on being connected with ourselves, with the universe, which includes being connected with each other. Bring your hands up to your heart center. Namaste position. Bow your head to your hands. Open your eyes as your gaze is down. Bring your head up. Let's start to move. So we're going to breathe in and bring our hands up above our head. And breathe out and widen up our hands. right down to the side of the front. And then as we breathe in, we're going to turn our palms up. As we breathe out, bring those hands back down to your heart center. If you can, breathing in. As you breathe out, see if your fingertips can touch the water.
Same thing with your legs. Breathing in
that. it on the board. Excellent. We've got the knee. And we're going to come forward into your baby cover. Good. Put back into child's pose. Excellent. Tap those toes and come up into your downward facing dog. Now your belly to pull onto your knees. Roll your shoulders a little forward and then roll all the way up and just down. So roll up, one vertebrae at a time. Really curving that spine. Both hands drop, roll up and forward. Roll up, roll up, roll up, roll up. Get the neck to come up. Drop those shoulders back and down. And side to side. Beautiful. Back and up. Breathing in, coming halfway up and do is come over there. That we're going to bring out. Now, in the breath, we're going to bring our feet to the earth and our hands to the earth. We're lengthening out high, halfway up. Beautiful. Halfway up and lengthening. And then we're going to start by lifting the front, going forward. We're going to go all the way up. Down, 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 down.
I'm all good. Better now.
Okay, you just popped into the water to get a little cool. Alright, so for our boat pose today, we're going to start by hooking our hands behind our knees and just bringing our feet without losing the integrity of that spine. Remember? Keep your spine nice and straight, shoulders open, heart center open. And let's see if we can bring those feet up a little. What would you say? Parallel with the knees, without losing the integrity of that spine. Yeah? And now, let's see if you can release your hands. Bring them out to the side. Come down when you're ready. That looks good. Now bring your feet together. Butterfly pose. Straighten up that spine again. If you want to, you can bow to me to know if it feels good for you. So we're going to do a couple of lying poses now, and so I think it might be good for you just to watch the sequence first. I'll explain what we're going to do. It's more difficult to see, and I don't want you to twist your legs. So we're going to do bridge pose first. I have also this little problem with my heart, so I will come further forward. But you want to have the centre of your back over your arm. Yeah? So for bridge pose, I touch my toes to my heel, my legs are in line with my hips, and I'm just propping up. If it feels good for you, you can interlace your hands underneath and come up a little further on your shoulders, yeah? To get some more height from your hips, yeah? So down you come onto your back. Center of the back in the arm, beautiful.
Yep.
Yep, looks good. Bring those heels in so that your fingertips can touch the heel. Unfolding, mm-hmm. Folding those legs. Okay, see the outside of your right foot needs to be parallel with the ball. I'll come in. Same pose, one more time. You want that butt to be nice and flat. bring your feet out to the outside edge of the board, the rail of the board. Keep your knees bent. Yep, keep your knees bent. Relax that neck down. Relax your neck down. Okay. Just leave your feet out towards the outside of the knees pressing together. How's your shoulder stand in your land practice?
Good. Moving it there. I can try.
You want to try on the board?
Yeah.
Okay, so do you want to pop up and that's how I do it on the board?
Yeah.
Okay, so same thing. You want to have your shoulders coming onto the arm, right? To me, because of my little hole, I need to come a little further to it, yeah? So if you shoulder stand on the board, I like to move into halasana first, which is the pose where your legs are all the way over the back. It kind of gives you some stability on the board, and then you can bring one leg up and then bring the other leg up. So I'm going to demonstrate to you, and then I'll get off the board and come over and talk to you with your shoulders. Okay? Okay. So first of
all the way over into the halasana. Yeah.
stretch out, and the arm goes, stretch out again. When you're ready, you can roll over to your right hand side.
Thank you, Sarah.
No worries.